When we talk about deformation, it's not just the shortening or lengthening of size or the length of member. We also experience change in shape, and so that's part of shearing, shearing deformation, which is caused by shearing forces or shearing stresses. So here we have shear strain, which is just the change in angle. No? So, for example, if you have this element, rectangular element, which is having length L here and subjected to shearing forces or shearing stress, so it's expected to deform in this direction. So from the original shape of rectangle, it will change to the dashed line, and then the measure of deformation here, the shearing deformation or shearing strain, is your gamma or shear strain. And then you have the deformation here is this one, much in a symbol, but we're concerned with this one. So the shear strain is just the deformation divided by the length. So if you're wondering why, because it's a trigo, no? It's just supposedly it's be tangent gamma equals this one, no? But since we're talking about a very small deformation, no? Infinitesimally small deformation, and this is a very small element, we can somehow say that tangent theta is just equal to, or tangent gamma is just equal to gamma. So that's why your shear strain is computed as this one. And then you also have the modulus of elasticity in shear, which is the modulus of rigidity. So remember, the modulus of elasticity in normal stress, we have our normal strain, we have E. So here for shear strain, we have the G for shear. So that's the modulus of rigidity, which is just the ratio of your shear stress and your shear strain. So that's it, no? And then we have the relationship between your shearing deformation and your shear force. It's just this one. So remember, the strain, it's a normal strain, is equal to PL over AE. You also have the deformation here. In terms of strain, in terms of shear, is we have VL over ASG. So somehow, if you remember the deformation, not the strain, sorry. The deformation caused by your axial stress is PL over AE. So PL over AE, so similar na sila, but now the deformation in terms of shear caused by your shear force is because is VL over AS over G, or ASG, where V now is your force and your AS is your subjected area, the sheared area. And since V over AS is just tau, or the shear stress, you can have this one, tau L over G. So again, this is deformation because caused by your shear force. The PL over A is deformation caused by your axial forces. So we also have Poisson's ratio. Poisson's ratio is just the ratio between your ratio of your longitudinal strain and your transverse or sidewise strain or deformation. So here in this example, we have an element here which is subjected. You have tensile forces in the x direction, so you're expecting a longitudinal deformation or strain in the x direction, and the transverse or sidewise deformation are in the y and z direction. So Poisson's ratio is V, which is denoted by V, is just the ratio of the transverse or sidewise strain or deformation over your longitudinal strain or deformation. So same with the other dimension. So the negative sign is there to denote that you're expecting a shortening or contraction along the transverse or sideways direction. So for steel, you have value of V in the range of 0.25 to 0.3. For concrete, we have 0.2. So you also have biaxial deformation. So biaxial deformation is when you have simultaneous but you have simultaneous stresses in two directions. So you have X and Y, for example. So your strain in the X direction is just is computed like this. No? This is this represents your strain in the longitudinal direction, and then you have the strain in the y direction, because you're expecting that this part here will be stretched, and then this part here will be compressed. So because of the simultaneous action of your forces, stresses, you have a lengthening on your longitudinal side and shortening on your y direction. So if this actually just came from your Hooke's law, no? So you have Hooke's law states that your stress just proportional to your strain, and then you have the E as the modulus of elasticity. So your E is just equal to, or your strain is just equal to stress over E, which is this one, essentially this one. This is in the X direction, and then this one just came from the Poisson's ratio, where V is just equal to negative EX. Since we're talking now about the Y direction, so you have the EX over EY, and then we're concerned with again the EX because of that shortening. So EX is equal to V negative a negative V EY, and then EY is just stress Y over E. So you have that one. So these are both strain in the X direction, but you're considering the action of the stress at the Y direction. So that's why we have that one. So same with the strain in the Y direction, just baliktad lang, no? We also have triaxial deformation. So triaxial deformation is when you have simultaneous actions of stresses in the three dimensions. So you have X, Y, and Z. So it's somehow similar with the biaxial deformation, only that we have additional dimension. So because of this, if you take out the common term, you'll have EY equals 1 over E times this one, stress Y, minus V, stress X. So since we're adding another dimension where stress is also acting on, you're adding another dimension here or here, no? So that's the triaxial deformation. So we have triaxial, biaxial, the use of Poisson's ratio, and then you have the shear strain. So sample problems will be on separate video.